It's a distance call out that way.
Kōkako are known as the ghost of the forest. This is because they can be quite elusive and hard to find. Their song is quite loud and a bit eerie.
So we know the Kōkako call when we hear it.
The Ark in the Park area in the Waitākere Ranges is a pest controlled area. The North Island Kōkako are listed as near threatened, but they're also classified as recovering, and this is due to the conservation efforts such as pest control. So the reason we do a Kōkako census is to determine the number of birds out in this area, and that's to see if the population is growing or declining or remaining stable.
See you guys at the end. Hey. We've got a lovely rope to climb up. So this pink tape is help marking our way through the bush. This is what we follow to be able to find our way. This one here, there's some double tape and a pink triangle, which is just marking the bait station. So we've reached our first census point. So we survey every 200 metres in the bush. We will stop for 5 minutes. We will listen to see if there are any kōkako in the area.
We use playback, which is kōkako calls, to draw the kōkako in.
Because the kōkako are territorial, they don't like other birds in the area, so they'll come to investigate to see what's going on. So I heard a very distant mew, which is part of the kōkako call, but I haven't seen anything. So now we're going to head further south down our line, and then we will do the same census sequence over again.
Ark in the Park is a partnership between Forests and Bird and Auckland Council. Quite a lot of the work involved in carrying out the census is done by volunteers. They do an amazing job and we're very thankful for all of their help. The annual Kōkako census is quite a lot of work. We go out daily for 8 to 10 weeks. At least 2 to 3 of us going out every day for the duration of this time. It does take quite a while as the area is quite large and we have to survey every 200 metres whether there are kōkako known in the area or not to determine if there are new birds in the area, original birds still using the same territories, or if birds have moved to new territories.
I heard that. Was that you or a kōkako?
It was not me.
Awesome. I think it's between me and you. They're close. Hey Erin, I've got one unbanded bird. There's definitely a second bird, but it hasn't come in yet.
We've just got to 14 on our line. We're finally starting to hear kōkako. So we've just had a radio call from Casey, who's on the next line over. She's got some birds calling northwest of her, so we've actually just heard them out over this way. So we're just going to wait to see if we can hear them a little more, and then we'll do some playback and try and draw them in.
So our skills come in handy out here during the census. This is very similar to what we do every day in the zoo. We need to sight our birds and make sure our birds are doing well. It feels great being able to use the skills that we have learnt at the zoo out here in the wild. It feels like it's contributing to a greater cause.
This is our last bait station, last chance to see some birds on our census line. So we're hearing some birds northeast. They might be a bit far away, but we'll give it a go at calling them in. Sounds like kōkako.
It might be just in the back of this tree here, or just in a tree behind that.
Can you hear them?
So this is an unbanded bird. Sounds like it might just be a single bird, but it's an adult because he's singing full song. So if it's an unbanded bird, it's been born here in the Ark in the Park area. It's pretty amazing. I get quite excited when we actually get to see them because they're not always the easiest birds to see.
I was hearing birds up one or two bait boxes up this way, up my line. So we're going to go around because this track loops around to the other side.
Yeah.
And they're spending a lot more time over there. So we're going to try and get them.
Yeah.
Cool.
Just go.
Cool.
This project is quite important to me. Because the kōkako is one of New Zealand's endemic species, I think it is really important that we can do all we can to try and make the species thrive in its environment.
Oh, there's two. There's one up here and one still over there.
So this kind of project is one of the reasons I got into working with birds. I enjoy getting out of the city, into the bush, into where the actual wildlife is, seeing how they behave in their natural environment. In the future, it would be really amazing to see kōkako in a lot of forests around New Zealand. By supporting us at Auckland Zoo, you're helping enable us to carry out conservation projects like this one.